I want you guys to cheer for SDP. Can we do it? 1, 2, 3. SDP! 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 Well done! Give yourselves a round of applause. And now, ladies and gentlemen, presenting your MCs for today, please put your hands together and welcome on stage, Ben Leighton and Jess Lingo.
Hi, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to SDP's first lunchtime rally. Good to see everyone there. Can everyone hear us? Thank you very much. And this is my colleague, Jeffrey George.
Good afternoon, everyone. Yeah, it's a nice, warm Thursday afternoon. All right, thanks for taking time out from your lunchtime to hear this rally. It's a very important one. We've got a good lineup of speakers this evening. All right, the first one we've got is Mr. John Tan, who's a candidate for Sembawang GRC.
Alec Tok.
Sorry, our first speaker is Mr. Alec Tok. He is our candidate for Bukit Panjang SMC. Let's put our hands together and welcome Mr. Alec Tok. So, Jin Yen, we know Bukit Panjang, 3选区的候选人.
Good afternoon, friends, family, fellow Singaporeans. I'm Alec Tok of the Singapore Democratic Party. The Singapore of today is the metropolis that was promised us by the first government of independent Singapore to our parents and to our grandparents. Having been born and bred in Singapore, and having seen the transformation of this island state of ours, it was nothing short of exhilarating and awe-inspiring. I was inspired by the acuity of vision of those first men and women who stood here at many a lunchtime rally as they cajoled and persuaded the chettiars, moneylenders, the clerks, the stenographers, the telex machine repairmen, the tongkang boatmen, and many, many others to give them a chance. The first group of men and women who came here cajoled and persuaded these Singaporeans who made up the different strands that made Shenton Way, Boat Quay, Raffles Place the colourful one that it always was and still is. Well, the Singaporeans responded to the dream that was being held out for them when these leaders said, "Come, follow me," and they did. And in the process, they succeeded. They succeeded in working together. They bonded with each other in the process. And they built a future together. But somewhere along the line, possibly the time when we started on our next lap, remember that? Next lap. This bond between Singaporeans and that first government began to fray, began to weaken. In fact, it was overtaken by higher ministerial salaries, asset enhancement schemes, the replacement of older leaders with those who were ushered in from the civil service and the army into government from behind the GRC scheme. existence became entrenched when imaginary boundaries were created to shape public discourse. When the government started to say, leave it to me, we are the government, let us govern, you just follow. Persuasion, cajoling, winning hearts and minds was replaced by telecom shares, economic restructuring shares, GDP figures, and international survey rankings. Those more good years became good for some, but not much better for many. Somewhere in the last 5-10 years, that weakening bond was suddenly, almost imperceptibly, without anyone noticing, that bond was severed, cut, no more. You break your scholarship bond, fine. We'll give loans instead and give scholarships to students from the region. You don't vote for us, fine. You stand last in line in upgrading. You don't appreciate what we have done for you, fine. We will welcome people from abroad. After all, Singapore is a place that people want to stay. But you see, by this time, the people no longer included us. By this time, it was no longer about Singaporeans, because we began to focus our attention on anyone else but Singaporeans, on anything else but the welfare of Singaporeans. Using the price mechanism, to mitigate everything, to solve every traffic congestion problem, parking problem, even shortage of ministerial talent, raise the price and forget about what it exacts from the ordinary Singaporean. These elections, nationwide, there is a consensus. Amid the tears and apology and standing corrected, amidst all this, a new group of young men and women have stepped forward. We have stepped forward to cajole, to persuade, to win your hearts and minds again. And ladies and gentlemen, fellow Singaporeans, this time we are winning. And we can understand why. We face intense economic competition globally. We have not solved the problem of job instability, nor the rising cost of living, stagnant wages, and the ever-widening income gap. We have had the spur stuck into our hide. We have been told to be cheaper, better, and faster. We find ourselves stretched to breaking point by overcrowded trains and runaway healthcare costs. And it seems only we are suffering. Those leaders go for their French cooking classes. Eight-month bonuses are still the norm. And the PAP doesn't look like it's got an alternative plan. And so, therefore, we must have an alternative plan. And it will be called the People's Alternative. In the course of this afternoon, my colleagues here at the SDP will share with you our vision for Singaporeans, placing Singaporeans first and foremost in all that we say, think, and do. We will explain our alternative budget, our alternative healthcare plan, our alternative town rejuvenation program, and our alternative economic regeneration plan. But first, we promise you, we will ask you for your views, your input, your feedback. Because as modern, well-traveled, and highly motivated people, we want to be treated with civility, with equality, and with respect. We will try, just as many across the island this past week have been doing, we will try to persuade you, to convince you, to inspire you to vote for us. There is no mistake about it. There is no mistake about it. There is change in the air. Not just the young are feeling it. You have seen it and felt it at the rallies each night. The old, the forgotten, the neglected, we are all feeling it. Change is in the air. Change is around the corner. Change is 2 days away. And we as Singaporeans are beginning to understand what it means to be holding our own destinies in our hands once again. Our vote, and we will give it to those whom we can bond with, whom we can trust, whom we can respect. Vote wisely, vote calmly, vote seriously, but vote opposition! Vote!